Yes, please come.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Come. How are you?
I'm good, sir.
First of all, congratulations on last year again, once again. Yes. So, what is your training going well?
Sir, I have to join Sunil. That's in the training of Delhi and Nandimani Naval Service.
Yes. So, when will that be? Otherwise, I mean, you are to join a post there or training now?
Training, sir.
Training. So when will I join?
I think it will commence around March.
Right. So are you satisfied with your exam last year and you feel that you did well but you can do better? Is that the situation?
Yes, I can definitely improve better upon my mains marks I had worked upon. Even on my communication skills I had worked upon this time.
Yes.
That I can perform better in the personality.
So, how many marks you got in your personality test last time?
150 marks.
150 was not a bad score. You'll do better this time, I'm sure.
Yes.
Okay, so first introduce yourself a little bit and tell us about yourself.
Yes, sir. So, my name is Dr. Gursimrat Singh. I belong to the city of Patiala from Punjab state. I have done my primary and secondary education from Patiala. Thereby, I did my graduation in MBBS. From Government Medical College and Rajendra Hospital, Patiala. So my hobbies are, I am a national level basketball player. I perform the folk dance of Punjab, that is Bhangra. Also, I like to read about Punjabi literature. So my friends and peers around me find me a person with jovial personality and positive outlook.
Excellent. So let's start with the positive outlook which you mentioned at the end. What do you see is the position of the country as a whole today? What are the positives and what are the negatives? You can take up the economy, you can take up the society, whichever aspect you like.
Sir, as a whole, India is doing really well on various fronts. Like in the economic front, we have now become the fifth largest economy in the world by crossing the $5 trillion mark. On the societal front, yes, there are many challenges, like we have a huge population and there are social inequalities, but we have eliminated poverty on a large scale. Recently, there was a report by the United Nations that we have eliminated around 271 million people out of poverty in the past decade. So we are doing well on the various fronts. Recently, we have held the presidency of G20 as well, and we are trying to hold the world order and shape it in a way that we believe in the ideas of Vasudeva Kutumbakam and world peace.
Okay. Now, tell me more, any strengths that you see India has going forward in the next 20 years?
Yes, sir. India has the largest youth population in the world. So, sir, we can reap the demographic dividend as we have the potential in our younger population. Apart from that, we have a larger market. And we believe in the economic trade and globalization. Apart from that, we can be the Vishwa Guru by exporting to the world. We are the pharmacy hub of the world. So we can even increase our potential on that front. And also on the cultural front, we believe in the values of universal brotherhood and harmony. We can shape the world peace and spread our values which we aspire for.
You mentioned two areas, pharmacy and culture. Any other areas where India is strong at the global level?
India is strong in various terms, economically, politically as well. We are the world's largest democracy. And sir, in industries, we are trying to increase our strength by increasing our manufacturing sector. We have a huge diaspora and we shape the politics across the world as well.
Okay, what about the population? There is a statistic which says that India's population will stabilize in a certain year. And already it is probably overtaking China. But there is a cutoff by which it is likely to stabilize. And then the global population would also stabilize. So in that scenario, do you think you are looking forward to that? Because then the unending depletion of resources and distribution in a large population will stop. And then probably we'll have a better scenario.
Sir, I believe yes, we have achieved the total replacement fertility rate, that is of 2.1, and our population is stabilizing. But yes, we will surpass China soon by the end of 2030, and our population will increase, and but it will soon stabilize after 2050s. So, but we are in a golden era of
2050.
Yes, sir.
From 50s. Okay.
So we are in a golden era of stability of the population, but as well as our younger population being the maximum in the world. So we can utilize the economic workforce or of the potential of our, the workforce of the youth. So we are in the golden era to reach the demographic.
What are the challenges before the youth today? What is facing the youth? What are they likely to encounter in the future? Is the mindset of the youth after pandemic especially, is it positive? Do you think there is something lacking? Is there any pressure on them? Or what do you see the scenario vis-a-vis the youth as a whole?
So yes, there are many challenges that the youth has to face or is facing. Particularly after the pandemic, yes, there is quite apprehension of how they'll employ themselves or how will they reset themselves with the new normal. So yes, there are particular challenges. They are trying to be a part of the economic workforce by boosting their skill set and be employable, so that they can be a part of the Indian citizenry by boosting, contributing in the workforce. So there are particular challenges which they have to face.
So counseling etc. has to be done at school level and college level, because many of them are under severe pressure, and there is a obviously large amount of competition for each job in the country. Yes. And the population is still much more than this country can sustain. So that lots has to be done. So what are some of the measures maybe that can be undertaken at a micro level?
Yes, sir, at the micro level, the counselors, they can be employed, or the service counselors, they can be employed at the school and college level. They can take care and of the needs of the youth, their skill set, and tell them the employment opportunities available, so that they don't stress and they can overcome their challenges, and they can lead a very productive life by overcoming those challenges, so that we can employ those at the micro level. Apart from that, we can even spread awareness on the social media as well. We should counter the misinformation on social media, and specific schemes or campaigns can be launched, like the recent there was a program of ASEAN, of employee-employer relationship, etc. So that even in Punjab we have the Ghar Ghar Rozgar Yojana. So that by these job fairs and by these employment opportunities, the youth can know about them and they can participate in them.
Have you heard of Arunima Sinha, and who is now authored a book on Mount Everest also?
No, sir, I have not.
So she is one of example of somebody who overcame challenges like you were talking. And yes, she also had both her legs were destroyed in an accident, and then she went on to get artificial limbs and climbed Mount Everest. And she was earlier a volleyball player. Last question that I had before I pass on. Good governance, e-governance, how much of an impact have they made in governance in the country? Maybe one or two examples also of initiatives which have improved transparency and service delivery.
Yes, sir, good governance or e-governance is a part of good governance, which uses information communication technological tools to boost the governance and provide them to the last mile by using technology, sir. So it has increased the transparency and accountability in the governance. Talking about some initiatives, so the national level PM Swamitva scheme, it utilizes the e-governance to provide digitalization of land records. It has been launched by the Ministry of Rural Development and Panchayats. So apart from that, sir, the recent use of e-technology during the COVID by the Arogya Setu app and the COVID platform. Lately also we have launched the latest vaccine called IncoVac, which is the first intranasal vaccine to be launched on the COVID platform. So through e-governance, we are spreading such a good information to the last mile of the public, so that they get aware of the services available. So these are the two.
Any state which is doing particularly well, and any state level initiative that you know of, apart from Punjab?
Sir, in Rajasthan, there are Jan Sunwai Kendras. They provide e-governance and welfare schemes through that portal. And e-Bhumi project in Karnataka, it provides a digitalization of land records by the state.
Okay, good.
Simrat, if you have to argue India's case for permanent seat in the United Nations Security how will you go about it? You will given this task, that is, what is the argument you will give in favor of India finding a permanent seat?
Yes. So I believe India has a very strong case to be a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council. We are the world's, first we are the world's largest democracy, and we have such a good record of our political stability and the system worldwide since our independence. Apart from that, sir, we have sent the largest UN peacekeeping forces to the world. So we believe in the dictum of world peace and Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which holds our claim of the United Nations Security Council seat. Apart from that, India has emerged as a developing and developed power by crossing the $5 trillion mark. So we are economically also stable, and we forge for being the regional superpower as well. And we are leading in various initiatives, such as the International Solar Alliance, which is headquartered in Gurugram. And we believe in the world peace and world prosperity, sir. Also, lately we are chairing the G20 grouping, so that we can shape the world according to our needs. Yes.
Sir, tell me something about Tawau. What happened in Yangtze? Where is Yangtze? What is the Yangtze name? What is it? Is it a town? What is it, Yangtze?
Sir, Yangtze is a region in the Arunachal Pradesh.
Is that a river?
Sir, it's a river as well.
It is a river. Okay, so it flows parallel to the LSE.
Yes, sir.
And what happened at Tawau, and what is the genesis of this problem?
Yes, sir. Sir, there was a recent clash there between the Indian Army and the Chinese Army along the LSE border, sir, in the Tawang sector. Sir, the genesis of the problem is that the line of actual control is not demarcated. So we have different understandings of the LSE. It has not been demarcated along various sectors. So that is the dispute there, sir.
You heard of backbone line?
Yes.
What is backbone? What does it mean? What does it mean?
Sir, McMahon line was after the independence and the Chinese war. It was
who was McMahon?
Sir, not aware who particularly the person was.
Actually, tell me something about Nepal, the new developments in Nepal.
Yes.
Should India be worried about this? What is the problem? Why are we concerned about the latest development in Nepal?
Yes, sir. Sir, the new PM of Nepal, Sir Mr. Prachand, he has taken the chair. So India has good ties with Nepal. We have the historical relationships and civilizational ties with Nepal. But yes, the incumbent government, they also are pro-Chinese. They have apprehensions that they are a buffer in between India and China. But they also support the Chinese government in various projects. So we have to maintain our ties with Nepal through our neighborhood first policy and spread goodwill in our neighborhood as well.
Russia has put a kind of ceiling on the fuel prices.
Yes.
Some countries which are doing that, and Russia says that we will not supply the fuel to those countries which go by that cap. What is that cap, and why is it worrying Russia?
Sir, there are some sanctions by the Europeans and Americans on the. They have capped the Russian oil so that they doesn't aid the war and their economy. So they have put a particular cap, and also during the supply chain crisis, so that they don't fleece the prices of the oil. So to avoid that and to break the economy of Russia, so that they don't continue the war for long. So they have done that.
One takeaway from the Ukraine-Russia war?
Sir, they are both positives and negatives. Sir, I'll start with the positive, that India has now maintained its strategic autonomy. It has been able to balance its relations with US as well as Russia. We vouch for the peace, and we are trying to negotiate with Russia as well as Ukraine. So we have been up to our diplomacy. Sir, the negatives will be, yes sir, it has created a lot of loss of lives and property there, and it has disrupted the economy across the world, the supply chains, and it has led to inflation and recession across the world.
Nothing about Zelensky's leadership?
Yes, sir.
Zelensky's leadership?
Yes, sir. He has shown immense leadership. Mm-hmm. He has not ran away from his constitutional post, and he is leading a small country by example. His bravery and courage is to be emulated by other leaders as well across the world.
Okay, I'll just ask you one last question. That is about, you read Punjabi literature a lot.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now, who wrote Khooni Vaisakhi? And when? What happened with that? That is a great event in the history of
Sir, I am not sure, but I think it has been written by Nanak Singh.
You are sure it has been written by him?
Yes.
Yes. What was, where was Nanak Singh that time? Was he there in Jalalabad that time?
Sir, I am not aware.
Nanak Singh was 22 years old and he was in Jalalabad that particular day and he wrote this. It was banned by the British. His grandson, Navtej Suri, who is a diplomat, Navtej Suri, he has now translated it and it has come in the world once again. So Nanak Singh, he wrote about 59
books. Narai Singh has written on Jallianwala
Bagh.
No, no, Navtej Sarna also.
Navtej
Sarna wrote a novel on Jallianwala Bagh. He wrote a novel on Jallianwala Bagh.
Yes, sir.
I'll
go and read this book, sir.
So, Jeet Patar. Tell us something about this man. What does he write? Does he write prose, poetry, what?
Yes, sir. So, Jeet Patar, he is also the president of Punjab Bhasha Academy in Ludhiana. Sir, also he has written poetry of various genres.
Okay.
So he is a great poet of Punjab. Also, he has received the Sahitya Academy Award in Punjab Literature.
Padma Shri also.
Padma Shri.
So, Nrisimhrath, as you are a doctor, right?
Yes.
So recently, you might have heard about China's COVID virus.
Yes.
So should India be worried about that? And what steps India should take regarding this?
Yes, sir. There was a recent spurt in cases in China lately. Sir, that is due to their relaxation of their zero COVID policy. Also, there is a lack of vaccine coverage in China, which is around just 40%. Yes, India needs to be worried about it. We have to be prepared. And we are the health ministry, they have sent the message that we need to follow the COVID appropriate behavior and increase our vaccination drive. Lately, we have launched the first intranasal vaccine as well, and we are trying to cover the vulnerable population in the booster doses. So yes, sir, we need to be prepared for any future exigency. But as a positive, we have 70-80% coverage of vaccinations.
Should we stop the flights from China? Can it be a positive or it is a negative step?
Sir, if the cases are increasing there, the flights can be stopped for some time or a proper isolation period can be launched for them. The people who come from the foreign flights, they need to proper go through the RT-PCR test and they need to quarantine for 10 to 14 days, that incubation period, and then they can go for further tourism.
And what are the five problems of Punjab?
Sir, some of the problems of which Punjab is facing. So first will be the drugs issue, which is rampant in the state of Punjab, unfortunately, because it is a border state and external state actors are also involved. Sir, apart from that, sir, groundwater depletion, which is due to the historical green revolution and the monoculture of wheat and rice. So third will be the deteriorating law and order issues because of the external state actors involved. There are some killings lately in the Punjab of a famous singer as well as some political person as well. So, but we are trying to curb these incidents by forming the anti-gangster task force the government has formed. So apart from that, there is an agriculture distress. So that needs to be made remunerative, which has led to the problem even of stubble burning. So on the air pollution front, we are trying to incentivize the farmers so that they move from such practice and use machines such as Happy Seeder and Super Seeder. So, but on a positive front, there was a reduction of 30% of cases this year.
And what are your points on freebies?
Sir, yes, Punjab has a huge debt burden of 3 lakh crores. So, I believe, yes, freebies, if they are very rational, if they provide welfare to the people, they should be rationalized, and that is a good step. But not everything can be given free to the people. That will create a bad narrative. And I also believe in the dictum of, if you give a man a fish, he will eat it that day. And if you teach a man how to fish, he will be richer forever. So I believe in that dictum.
That's a good dictum.
Yes.
Okay. Can you give the name of the mascot as well as the motto of just concluded FIFA World Cup?
I'm not aware of.
Not aware, you didn't follow?
Sir, I followed that it happened in Qatar and Argentina won the
World Cup. Argentina won, okay. Can you give any major news from today's newspaper? Any major?
Yes, sir. Sir, today there was a news regarding the India-Manipur pact that the central government and the Manipur, they have signed a peace pact with the outfit of ZUF, ZLN, United Front.
What is Netaili?
Sir, that is a community in Manipur, sir.
Are you sure or is the language?
Sir, there is a Maithili community in Manipur, sir.
And can you just differentiate leader, administrator and a reformer? And with the example.
Yes, sir. Sir, leader will be who leads from the front. He leads a proper program or a campaign and he has a proper vision. He leads the whole team. Sir, administrator will be, he is also a leader, but it will be a subgrouping of a leader who is dealing with the administration. So, a leader who is dealing with the administration front, he will be an administrator. Like our bureaucracy, they hold, the IAS officers hold the administration front, they will be an administrator. And they are the good leaders if they follow the principles of the code of conduct.
And reformers?
Reformers, it will be a visionary leader who reforms the status quo, the bad practices or the bad evils. He reforms some of the practices which are prevailing. To reform the society, he will be a reformer.
Can you give an example of any major reform in Indian society?
Yes, sir. Historically, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Sir Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar.
So, who would you like to be in long term? Administrator only, a leader or a reformer?
Sir, I will be a good leader who is also a good administrator and reform the society of all the evils.
But every manager has to be a leader and every leader has to be a manager.
Yes.
No?
Yes.
You can't be a good leader unless you are a good manager too.
Yes.
And if you are a manager, you should also be a leader, otherwise you are not a good manager.
Yes, you have to balance all that.
And what, can you describe mutation? Because this word is now become buzzword in last year since COVID outbreak. Can you just explain for a common person what is mutation?
Yes, sir. Mutation is the change in the genetic sequence. Especially the virus, they have tendency to mutate. So they change their genetic sequence to evade the antibiotics. Recently, the COVID virus, it mutated to form the new lineage of virus.
Is the current strain what is creating havoc in China? Can you give the exact strain name?
Yes, sir. It is BS7 variant in China. Yes.
And can you name Indian scientists who have awarded Nobel Prize in medicine for cracking genetic code?
Sir, I'm not aware of it.
Dr. Hargobind Khurana.
Yes, sir.
And who gave this mutation theory? Because this is a Western concept in which when we are studying evolution in biology, you are MBBS doctor. So who gave this mutation theory of evolution?
Sir, Charles Darwin.
Charles Darwin gave the theory of natural selection.
Mendel?
Yes, sir.
Mendel said, was close, but the Hugo de Vries. Mendel.
Hugo de
Vries. Okay. What is your strength and weakness as an individual? One final question from my side.
Yes, sir. As I have introspected, some of the strengths are, sir, I believe I have held various leadership positions and I am a good leader. Apart from that, sir, I believe in teamwork. And I try to solve problems very innovatively and try to think for the out-of-box solutions. Apart from that, sir, during my medical graduation, I try to imbibe the traits of empathy and compassion as well.
Just a minute. Being a sportsman,
yes,
has it helped you in any way? What way has it helped?
Yes, sir. Definitely being a sports person. Sir, the first big thing I have learned is the leadership skills and also how to work in a team and be very disciplined in life. And secondly, sir, how to handle victories and defeats by being the same. It has taught me really well that how to bounce back from a defeat and overcome those challenges.
Okay, before we close the interview, why is basketball a great sport? What is great about it?
Sir, basketball is a great sport. It involves, it is a team sport and follows five players from both the sides. So it is game, it is a very energetic sport. Tall players play and it is a very, one basket, it happens just in a span of 24 seconds. So it is a very energetic and a fast sport.
Name one very tall basketball great and one not so tall basketball great. You said tall.
Yes, sir. Sir, a tall basketball great will be, sir, I follow Satnam Singh from Punjab. Okay. He is apart from Dallas Mavericks team and he's 7 feet. Hmm. Sir, a short basketballer and a great will be Mr. Robinson. He is a part of Phoenix Lakers.
Any memorable moment from your basketball days? Anything you remember? Maybe the highlight?
Yes, sir. Sir, I went for the under-19 nationals. So, I got selected. There was a camp in Ludhiana Academy. So, I was picked from there and I went under-19s in my after my plus two there. So it happened in an academy in Chennai. So, we played there and we even won, our Punjab team won silvers in that.
Okay, good, Samrat. I think we close the interview. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
We'll give you some feedback and would you want to give us that? So you tell us first.